Hi, I'm Giorgio, the developer behind Waiterio. Today I'm going to show you how to use Waiterio to take orders, print invoices, and send orders with the rest of the staff of your restaurant. Visit waiterio.com on the browser of your computer. Then click on the button Sign Up on the top right corner. Enter your email. A password, a 4-digit PIN, all numbers, and then your first name and your last name. Your restaurant has been already set up. Let's start by customizing our menu. There is few items that have already been added for us, but we want to start fresh. So we click on a category and we choose to delete it. Let's delete also the main category. Now, let's create the menu of our Italian restaurant. So let's click on Add New Category, and let's add a category called Pizza. Let's add an item to the category Pizza named Margherita, and let's put the price to $6. Then let's add another item called Marinara, also for $6. Let's add another category called Drinks. Let's add an 1/2 liter bottle of water, and then a Coca-Cola. We can also add extra toppings to items. So for example, let's click on Margherita and choose Add New Extra, and let's add olives for $1. We can also add the toppings to an entire category. For example, let's add a topping named Mozzarella di bufala, $1. This extra topping is shared across all the items of the category. Let's create now our first order. Let's navigate to the Orders tab and let's click on New Order. We can add a couple of margaritas, a marinara, a water. By clicking here, we can add an extra margarita, making it to 3 margaritas. We can click on the button nearby to show the options. So for example, we want one of the margaritas to have olives. Then we want to add mozzarella di bufala to the marinara. We can also add one-time notes. So for example, the customer is gonna write marinara, and then we're gonna write no olives. All right, our orders has been finished. We can click on the send button to send the order to all the other devices of our restaurant. The order has been created and it's right here. We can also create orders from the tables tab. So, for example, we want to add an order for table 5. Let's click on the table 5 and let's add the item. We can edit the name of the order, the name of the table, right here. We can change it to table 2, or we can even change the name of the table to anything we want. So, let's change it back to 2. We're gonna send the order. And then, now, the order that has been added to table 2 is gonna appear right here. So, we have already learned about the table's orders, and then also about menu. Now, let's add one under members of our staff. So, this is us. This is actually me, Giorgio Zamparelli. I'm currently the admin of the restaurant. Let's add a waiter. So, let's say we're going to add Gino, the waiter, as another member of the staff. We can choose the role among all of these, but we're actually going to choose waiter this time, and we're going to invite him. Here we can see we have sent the invite to this email. Gino actually needs to log in within Waiterio to sign up using this very email we used to invite him. Let's go over the next tab, which is the reports, which the reports shows the overalls of all the orders we have taken so far. So for example, today we have taken two orders. This was the first one we took for $28, and this was second order for table two. Both of them, they were taken by me. And this is the total. You can review the total by each user. And then you can also see the numbers of each items of the menu that have been taken. So in total today, we had four margarita, and they made us earning $24. You can change the time range from today to anything available here. You can also export all the reports data of the past orders to CVS to open it in Microsoft Excel or the app numbers on macOS 6. You can also print these reports. Now, let's talk indeed about printing. You can add a printer, and there is many available options based on the type of printer we're going to use. But this time, let's use a computer driver printer. So this is a printer that has been installed on this very computer, and we have the driver to use it. So let's try to use it by, let's add a name for it. So we're gonna write driver printer, and then we're gonna print a sample. The computer driver printer will open the print dialog of the browser, and then from here we have to choose our printer from this part. Let's save the printer. And then we got it right here. We can use this printer to print invoices or also print orders as soon as they come out, as soon as they're taken by the waiters. So to do so, to print orders as soon as they're taken, we have to change this option right here, print orders, and set it to yes. Let's watch now the restaurant tab, which is essentially a general settings for your entire restaurant. You can change the currency of your restaurant, the payment methods available. So for example, let's add cash and credit card. You can add a service charge, tax. You can change the info of your restaurant. So let's change the name of my restaurant to Pizzeria da Giorgio. You can add also the information regarding the location of your restaurant that they will be printed within the invoice. You have finally the account tab where you can change other settings which are only regarding yourself. So these are personal settings and each user can customize them. You can see the roles that you currently have. You can choose whether you want to see the orders sorted by table name or some other. You can hide automatically paid orders. Actually here, hide paid, and then hide automatically after a certain amount of time. Show only mine orders. And you can also log out by clicking here on log out.